all those who have ears, they can hear. We are all young at heart. We are all children of God. So this story is for everyone. God told many miracles, parables to draw a lesson in the Bible. Can you guys name one parable in the Bible that we can remember? Okay. Well, he said, Aaron talked about a parable in the Bible about spreading of the seeds. Remember when the seeds were spread and some fell on the good ground and some fell on the rock? So that's one of the story how lesson is drawn. So we should be listening and practicing. So today's story is about a king. Long, long time ago, there lived a king, and he was a very good king. How many of you know there is one king that is awesome king? The king of the world. What's his name?
Jesus.
That's right. Jesus is the king of the world, right? King of kings. So just like that, there was a king who was very nice. He absolutely cared about his people. He didn't want anyone to suffer. So he was pretty happy about all the people in his kingdom. But even then, one day he decided, let me go and see how my people are living. So he went to many different places. If I take an example of India, maybe he went to Taj Mahal. He went to Golden Temple, he went to many other famous places. If you take America, maybe he went to Hollywood and Disneyland and Crystal Cathedral. Many famous places where people will be found. So after his few weeks of trip, when he was mingling with his people were so excited that the king himself came to talk with them. Did our king ever come to this world? In the beginning, when Adam and Eve were created, did Jesus used to come and talk with them? Yes, Samuel says yes. Absolutely. When Adam and Eve were created, God used to come and visit them every day. And they knew that God was the best. Right? So just like this, after a couple of weeks of traveling all across his kingdom, he came back and he was content. That means he was very happy that his people are living very well. They're not being bothered by anybody. They have enough to eat. But one thing bothered him the most. He complained to his cabinet members. He said, I'm glad that my people are doing great, but after this visit, my feet, they are killing me. I just cannot bear the pain. Because I think this was the first time he probably went walking so much. So he complained to his cabinet. He said, you know, one thing I noticed, people are happy, but the roads, oh no, there's too many rocks. They're stony. They're not paved correctly. And if my feet are hurting, what about my people? I walked only this one trip. They walk on these roads every day. So he kept thinking about it and he said, you know, we gotta do something for my people. I can't let this happen. He said, I order all of you to take charge, go throughout my kingdom, and pave every road in the kingdom with leather. So when my people walk on it, they will not be hurt. Wow. That was a tough command. And when I was reading the story, Reagan immediately said, that's expensive. That's a lot of work. And of course, those people said, man, we have to kill so many cows to pave the roads. That's absolutely not done. And of course, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, in the story of Daniel. Daniel was the wisest man. There lived another wise man in his kingdom. He came through. He said, Your Highness, I have a great idea. He said, yes, you can share your idea with me. He said, instead of paving the roads with leather, why don't we get a piece of leather and form it in the shape that will protect your feet and they won't be hurt. So he really applauded to the idea. He said, that's a beautiful idea. He said, immediately order me a pair and make sure my kingdom, everyone wears the same so their feet will not be hurt. Wasn't that a nice of that king? So the moral of the story is, rather than changing something else, we need to change ourselves. Right? And how can we change ourselves? We need the presence of God, right? We need God to renew our heart, that we will start thinking about others and not be selfish. King was a king. Nobody would ever question him whether the road was there or not, whether his feet were hurting or not. He didn't have to. Everybody was happy. But he thought about the little thing that bothered him so much. So he could have just gotten a pair of shoes just for himself, but no, he thought about the whole kingdom. This is how our Lord in heaven thinks about us. He makes sure that every need is met, and we're not running around material things in this life. So as we continue to worship, let's pray that God gives us a new heart. All right? Thank you.